Hello again! Thanks for tuning in to Seoul Museum Tour. I'm your host, Hana. And today, the exhibit that we'll be checking out is called Universe Whanki 1i21 Lotte Media Project. As you may have guessed from the title, the exhibit today will showcase the works of Kim Whanki, a contemporary artist who is hailed as the pioneer of Korean abstract art. Lotte collaborated with Whanki Museum to showcase the artist's work as media art installations. I hope you're ready to dive right into the world of Kim Whanki's signature blue. Let's go. Inside the exhibition hall, and over here you can see a caricature of sorts of Mr. Kim Whanki himself, the artist whose work we will explore in this program. Now, if you follow me here, you will see that the name of the exhibit is Universe Whanki 1i21 Lotte Media Project, and that's to say many of the works that you'll see at this exhibition are media installations of the more famous works of Kim Whanki. And Universe Whanki, as the name suggests, is referring to this painting right here, which is Universe 5-1V-71-200. Very long name. But this is the painting that Kim Whanki is most famous for, because this painting was sold for a very high price back in 2019. You can see it depicts these very intricate dots in blue, and this is what's known as the signature Whanki blue. This painting, I believe, was sold for 13.2 billion won at the Christie's auction in Hong Kong, and is one of the most highest sold paintings in the history of Korean art. So this is definitely one of the highlights of this exhibition. Let's now go into the exhibition hall to see what else we can see related to Mr. Kim Whanki. Alright, so this wall behind me is a nice display, I guess, the milestones in Mr. Kim Whanki's life. And you can see that he was born in 1913 and went to school in Tokyo. But after that, he traveled all over the world working on his craft. And as I mentioned earlier, he became a pioneer of Korean abstract art. And his activities were not only confined to Seoul and Korea, but he was also active in Paris. He was active in New York and in many other famous cities that became his stage for his art. Another thing that I want to note here is that he's shown in many of the pictures with his wife. And you can see her here. And you can see her here as well in Paris in 1957. And so yeah, you can see that he traveled a lot, and he traveled often with his wife as well. Through this display, you can learn a little more about the life and the work of Kim Whanki. Another thing I saw here is how you can sort of divide Kim Whanki's work into various periods. So from 1933 to 37 was his time in Japan when he was studying to become a student of art. Then you have 37 to 56 in Seoul, 56 to 59 in Paris, 59 to 63 back in Seoul, and then 63 to 74 in New York City. So he was very global, very well traveled, and I guess it's a good way to approach looking at his work by looking at where he was during that. wanted to tell you was that the reason why Kim Whanki is so beloved and so famous and well regarded as a pioneer of Korean abstract art is because he was such a master of combining technique and various elements, pulling from both the West and the East. So in other words, you can see that he painted this particular piece with oil painting on canvas, but there are a lot of Asian elements, or Korean elements to his painting. There's a vase here that you can see, something that looks like a gate that's quite representative of maybe perhaps a place like Gwanghwamun. And so yes, all of this combines to create a painting that's very modern, but at the same time very Korean as well.
자신의 작품 세계와 예술 철학을 끊임없이 되짚고 해체하고 재구성하는 치열한 인고의 과정을 통해 김원기는 한국 추상미술의 진일보한 서막을 열고 그 흐름을 이끌었으며 화가가 작고한 지 어느덧 반세기가 지나고 있음에도 불구하고 여전히 가장 뜨거운 예술적 화두로서 국제무대의 중심에서 한국 미술의 가치를 높이고 있습니다.
So let's just stroll and see all the blue that we will encounter. Blue. I guess from here the paintings become a little more abstract, more dots. And then we've arrived at the famous painting that was, you know, sold for a very high price. Universe 5IV71200. So I wanted to take some time to explain why this painting is named Universe 5IV71. Kim Whanki had a habit of naming his paintings in this particular way. What this means is that this painting was started on the 5th of April in 1971. And the number 200 means this is the 200th painting that he painted in 1971. So yes, it's a very good record of his work at the time. And this was painted fairly close to his death. But yes, it remains one of the most beloved paintings in his collection. By looking at your screen, but when you look at this particular painting up close, you can, you know, see the dots that Kim Whanki painted one by one, painstakingly using a very fine brush.
우리 한국의 하늘은 지독히 푸릅니다. 하늘뿐이 아니라 동해 바다 또한 푸르고 맑아서 흰 수건을 적시면 푸른 물이 들 것 같은 그런 바다입니다. 푸른 하늘, 푸른 바다에 사는 우리들은 푸른 자기, 청자를 만들었고 간결을 사랑하고 흰 옷을 입는 우리들은 흰 자기, 저 아름다운 백자를 만들었습니다.
This one is drawn in a similar style. Another one in a slightly brighter blue, but blue nonetheless. So I just spent some time writing out this poem that's written behind me, and this is apparently Kim Whanki's actual handwriting. He talks about people in the world and all of these stars in the sky. You just find that one special star or that one special person who speaks to you a little differently. And I think it's nice to think of this poem when you're looking at a lot of his blue paintings. So here's my piece of blue in my envelope to keep. about what I think of these amazing paintings. Let's go see what other people think of the exhibit today.
안녕하세요.
네,
혹시 영어로 인터뷰가 가능할까요?
네.
아, 정말요?
네. 네,
여기 잡으시고. So, in English right away.
Okay.
So, what was your impression of the exhibit today?
It was very interesting since it portrayed his piece with unique way, in digital ways, which I've never seen before.
Okay. And had you known about Kim Whanki before?
I really don't know about him really, but I only know that he had a drawing which is recorded as the most expensive one from Korea, which is called, I believe, Universe, right?
Right. And what's your favorite piece from this exhibit?
I think my favorite is the one at the entrance, which is obviously the Universe. Because that's the only one I'm familiar with.
I feel like I just walked out of a great big universe. It was at times like a giant ocean. But also when the background art changed, I felt like I was inside Kim Whanki's universe. It's an awesome experience. And I think it's one of the highlights of this exhibition for sure. Well, that's it for today, I think. I hope that all this blue that filled your screen brought you some peace and calm and made you fall in love with Kim Whanki's magnificent paintings. It certainly made me more curious about other artists of the 20th century. Okay, so please click like and click subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Otherwise, I will see you in the next episode. Bye-bye! Another special thing about this exhibit is that you can listen to an explanation of many of the artworks here from famous musicians. In this case, it's a musician named Jihye, who you might have seen from music programs like Begin Again. And yes, you snap the QR code so you can listen to him talk to you about this particular painting. And there's some extra information about the painting itself as well. It's pretty neat.